Well, with Christmas fast approaching, you are probably scrambling for those final gift ideas. But what to get the budding photographer in your life? Well, Jenny McCarthy got some expert advice on choosing a camera for all tastes and budgets.
Well, Christmas is here and gift shopping is in full swing. And with that in mind, I've come into Dublin city centre to visit Birmingham Cameras, where I'm going to find out what the best deals for cameras are this Christmas.
The spirit's up, we're here tonight, and that's enough.
So, Brian, we have a range of cameras here that are going to suit all budgets.
Yes, we do.
So we're going to start off with this little beauty here.
So this is a Canon model. It's called a Nixus 185. This will be the starting point of the digital cameras. It's got an optical zoom on it. It's got a screen in the back. It takes photos and videos.
Perfect. Our next one then is... How retro.
Yeah, it's the only non-digital camera that's here with us. It's the Polaroid, it's an instant camera.
Yeah.
So this takes the photo and you get the printed out straight away.
Brilliant. Great for kids as well, coming up to Christmas.
Great for kids, yeah, particularly Christmas morning or any sort of family occasions over the Christmas period. It's really nice for the kids to actually see a photo rather than have to look at a screen to see what photo has been taken.
And stick them into a scrapbook afterwards.
Exactly, that's it.
So our next one then, Brian.
Panasonic Lumix model. Mm-hmm. Just call it TZ80. Now this is still a non-interchangeable lens camera, but it has quite a long zoom on it for the physical size of it. It's got a 30 times zoom, so what that means is that at the end of the zoom, mm-hmm. you're 30 times closer than you were at the start of the zoom.
So really good for maybe wildlife photography or, you know, photography where you don't have to get too close to your subject.
That'd be it, exactly, yeah.
Excellent. So our next one then, Brian.
You're moving up to this one here now.
So this is a DSLR.
That is, yes.
Yes. I very often get asked about, you know, what is the entry level for DSLRs? Is this entry level?
This is entry level, yes. Okay. So I think when you mentioned the term entry level, sometimes it can do the cameras an injustice because they're really good nowadays. So even an entry level camera is a very good camera.
Sure.
This particular one is a Nikon model. It's called a D3500. Now this, being a DSLR, you can change the lenses on it. It has a point and shoot mode on it, so if somebody knows nothing about the camera, they can very easily use it. You can put it in the point and shoot mode and it will focus for you. It will do all of the settings for you.
Excellent. So our next one then?
Canon EOS M50.
Okay.
So this is a mirrorless camera.
Tell me what mirrorless is. Now I know, but for our viewers, what is a mirrorless camera?
So a mirrorless camera, the clue is in the name. It's a camera without a mirror. So what it means is similar to the DSLR we just looked at, you can change the lenses, but because it's a mirrorless camera, it's physically a lot smaller and a lot lighter. So if people are going away from a DSLR because they don't want that physical size or weight, a mirrorless camera would offer them an alternative to it.
The next one, I'm very excited about this one, Brian, because it can capture anything from macro settings to the moon.
Yes, yeah. So this is a Nikon model. It's called a Coupix P1000. Now, even though it's physically very big, you can't change the lenses on this. So you might look at it and think you can change the lens, you can't. But it does have a huge zoom in it. It has a zoom up to the equivalent of 3000 millimeters. Now, essentially that means that at the end of the zoom, you're over 100 times closer than you were at the start of the zoom.
So Brian, I get asked constantly, what camera do I use? And this is the beauty here, isn't it?
That's it, the Canon EOS 5D Mark IV. So that's it, I think you could tell me more than I could about this camera. But it's the top of the range in the Canon range. So if you are looking for something that is for professional quality, but also suits enthusiasts or people who just want to have the best quality in the range, this is the one to go for.
Mm-hmm. I've even seen videographers using this.
Yes, it takes photos, videos. It does video every bit as good as it does photo, and it does photo every bit as good as it does video. So it does pretty much everything for you.
So if you don't have a massive budget and you just want to use a stocking filler as a gift for Christmas, what have you got here? You have a few bits to show me.
Okay, yeah. So the first one is a cleaning kit. So this is an inexpensive gift. It's for if you're not sure what camera the person has, it's not model or brand specific.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. And I see you have a book down there. Tell me more about that.
So this is a book. It's the complete book of photography.
I recognise this.
Yeah, it's in the goodie bags we give to the prize winners from the Ireland AM Camera Club.
Yes.
So it's a really nice book. It's a really, really thorough book about photography and all things photography. It gives tips, tricks. Very, very nice gift to give anybody.
Great gift. And I think these are really cute down here, these little badges.
Yeah. These are pin type badges. You can see here they look like rolls of film or old film type cameras, so sure. They're quite retro. They've been very popular so far for gifts, people who collect badges, people who may have had one of these cameras before, had a particular favourite type of roll of film back in film days.
It's a great idea.
Really cool, yeah.
Brian, that's very comprehensive. Thank you so much for all of your help. I think there's something there now that's going to suit everybody's budget. And thank you very much for all of your help during the year as well with our camera club on Virgin Media.
No problem. Thank you.
That's it from us here. Everyone, Merry Christmas.